The last thing one would have expected on the way back to normalcy at the cinema theaters is a clash of two films. That's exactly what happens this week with two films, one starring John Abraham and Sandeep or Pinky Faraar, releasing on the same day. Finally, the audience ends up with a choice, a huge mental conundrum. Which of these should I avoid? Both are bad films, period. We'll deal first with Sandeep or Pinky Faraar, directed by Debakar Banerjee, who has a number of films to his credit, which includes Koslaka Ghosla, good film, Oye Lucky Lucky Oye, all right, light comedy, Love, Sex or Dhoka, There Begins the Angst, Shanghai, Bombay Talkies, that was bad. Detective Bomkesh Bakshi, flopped again. Love Stories, Ghost Stories. And it must be said that Debakar is just repeating his mistakes. He has the talent. There are flashes. But by and large, I think he tends to bite probably much more than his digestive system allows him to. Let's deal with this film on hand, Sandeep or Pinky Faraar. Now, typically you would have had Sandeep as the hero, Pinky as the heroine. Nobody wants to make a statement. Therefore, Arjun Kapoor plays Pinky and Pariniti Chopra plays Sandeep. Big deal, big change, big paradigm shift, big talent, big artistic indulgence. But that's it. That's what Debakar Banerjee indulges in. Story starts off with a stylized motor race, expletives used, Galia, and two cars racing in the dark of the night. And then there's a shootout. Then the car reverses, goes fast. We don't know what's happening, except that you know that in the car, there is Arjun Kapoor driving the car and Pariniti sitting in the back. Soon you come to know that Pariniti is a captive and that Pinky or Arjun is the man who's paid to kidnap Pinky. It goes sour, it goes bitter. It goes wrong all the way. Pariniti or Sandeep understands that it's a plan to kidnap, so she rushes into a party, a journalist party at that. She's a arrived banker in an affair with her boss. So there's gossip about her boss, there is her own star value at this meeting, but soon she moves out and she can't escape because Pinky, who's himself a suspended police cop, is trying to serve somebody's purpose and get back to work by running this errand. For the next 2 odd hours, the movie itself is for 2 hours and 6 minutes, you have Pinky and Sandeep trying to build a relationship, always flopping. We still don't know why Pinky wants to kidnap Sandeep or why he's not doing it full-heartedly. Why Sandeep is on the run till we almost at the end when it becomes very, very involved, very contrived. On the way, they meet uncle and auntie, and here comes the life of the film. As auntie, you have Nina Gupta, and as uncle, you have Raghubir Yadav. What performances! Not a great script, not a great role. How wonderfully the script lies on their shoulders. What genuine talent is, you would find, by how these two convert such a morbid story into something worth looking for and looking at. As the story progresses, you come to know that Pinky is under suspension. You don't know why. You know that Sandeep is pregnant, and the guess is that she has had an affair with her boss, who apparently she is trying to blackmail because she and he are hand in glove in a banking scam. She's a gold medalist. She's an arrived person. She's a top banker. No parallels, huh? And so we have, till the end, the parallel story of these two people running away. It's like so many, it happened one night, Roman holiday, Bate Kratki, Churi Churi, or you can name as many films as you can on the story about how a guy and a gal meet and are on the run with somebody on the chase. In most of the films that I named, specifically films like Churi Churi and Bate Kratki, the soul of the film was music, not to mention those very suave performances from the cast. Here, music is a huge letdown if music there is in the film. Yet, I would say Pariniti Chopra has that energy that makes good for a part of the film. She's miscast. I don't think the role is as well etched as it ought to be. Very half-baked. In fact, half-baked, half-boiled. Arjun continues that lost, awkward look, which is very nice at a time when every other hero is the six-pack, sure-hit guy. He's the antithesis to what the other heroes of our cinema are and brings in a very endearing awkwardness to his cinema, which I've said even before, and I believe that that's a value add even here. However, that's all and no more is what happens with both Arjun and Pariniti. In short, it's not about Sandeep and Pinky going Faraar. Very soon, it's the audience trying to do a Faraar. Stay away is what the film is all about. I know I've been back to you after a long time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for looking out. Thanks for telling me in person once in a way what's happened to my film reviews. It shows that many of you would like to watch or hear me talk about cinema. So thanks. Do send in your responses. Before I sign off, thanks to Datu, my cameraman, and Abhinav for editing the story. Bye-bye.